It's time for the match game, Hollywood Squares Hour, with from the hotel, Nathan Cook. From Night Court, Richard Moll. McLean Stevenson. Nedra. Charles Nelson Reilly. And the stars of the match game, Hollywood Squares are Gene Raver and John Bowman.
Very good. What are the better players? Hello there. Thank you.
Good thank you. Boy, we're going to have a wonderful time. Got them all riled up, eh?
Terrific. All ready down here? Have to go at it?
All ready.
Okay, what's the answer?
Not quite ready.
Hi, Gene.
Not quite ready.
Hi, Gene. Very health
conscious. Pure water, friends. I don't care what anybody says.
That's right.
That's right. That's true. Listen, the other day...
Easy.
I had Nedra stand up alongside you while you were seated, and she still only came up to here. I would be curious to see what you two would look like standing up.
Let's give it a shot. What do you say?
Stand up.
Okay.
Nose to nose as if you're having an argument. Or just... Listen, what if you were madly in love with her and wanted her to marry you?
Well, I think I'd say something like, let's get married and have normal-sized kids. What do you say?
Huh? Well, I can't tell you what I'd say.
Okay. We got the idea.
Nobody to talk to.
Nobody to talk to. All right, we got it.
All right,
what was that?
To talk to.
No, that's that.
All right.
You're both wonderful.
Thank you.
Thank you. I love
we
your jacket.
We get along just fine.
Would all of you stars join me in greeting our two players here, Debbie Bowman and Thurston Lemar.
Hey!
Lemar. The southern name.
Right, New Orleans.
We're going to find out about Debbie first. Let's hear about you, please.
Well, I'm in my 12th year as a flight attendant. I'm based in Atlanta, and I live in Bluffton, Indiana. I am married, and we have two Siamese cats. Started to say kids.
Wait a minute. Hold on. You got married and had kittens.
Hey.
Wait a minute, Debbie. Hold everything.
Better nothing.
We have two Siamese cats named Bonnie and Clyde.
Ah, good for you. They're wonderful creatures, aren't they? Yes.
Lovely.
All right, Thurston Lemar. Is that the way you say that?
Right.
That's a real southern name.
Right out of New Orleans.
Right out. Is that where you're from?
Right. I'm a private investigator, and I specialize.
See ya.
All right, hang around, you guys. Stick around.
I specialize in murder cases. I work mostly for attorneys.
Oh, all right.
Heavy duty.
Okay, we're mostly fraud and embezzlement
but
over here.
I've been accused of looking like B.B. King, but singing like Charlie Pride. And I love golf. I'm an avid golfer.
Really?
Yes.
And you play? Do you live in this area, or do you still live in New Orleans?
I live in Los Angeles.
Oh, you do?
Yes.
Yeah. And what's your handicap as a golfer?
Well, my club's going to find this out. I've been sandbagging. I carry an 8.
You carry an 8?
Yes.
McLean's a great golfer. What's yours?
36.
Oh. What an honest man. All right, good luck to both of you. We'll begin the match game now. You'll have 3 opportunities to match as many of the stars as you can. And the winner will go on to challenge a returning champion on Hollywood Squares for a chance to win up to $30,000. And we ask Debbie to go first because she won the toss.
A, please.
A it is. We're off and running. The devil said. He said... I've been looking over the records of all the people we have down here, and it's amazing how many of them used to work as blanks. Is that a good one, Debbie?
I hope so.
Okay. You ready? Nedra?
Yeah. I guess.
All right. Debbie, have you thought about this? Here it is. The devil said. I've been looking over the records of all the people we have down here, and it's amazing how many of them used to work as blanks.
Oh, I hope my nephew forgives me. He's a minister. Minister.
Ministers? Debbie, what are you trying to tell us here?
Wow.
Well, he's one of the good guys.
Your nephew is a minister, but he's one of the good guys?
Yes.
Well, you think there are a lot of them down there, Debbie?
Probably.
There are a few shysters.
Oh, no. There are.
I'm digging myself in.
Well, McLean.
When Debbie goes to that big game show in the sky.
They're going to close the door in her face.
Big guy's going to get her.
Yes, yes.
No, I went another way. I said politicians.
Politicians.
That's wonderful.
Excellent. What'd you say?
I wish I'd have thought of that politician
bit. You would have written it if you thought of
it? But I thought of another good one. MCs.
Wait a minute. Holy mackerel. Whoa. Oh, wait. She has her public defender there, Richard. What do you say?
The devil laughed and he said, so many of them used to be game show hosts.
Ah, pow, pow, pow.
If I stand up, you're in trouble.
That's right. I better beat a hasty retreat. Okay, John, what do you got?
Thanks for taking care of him. I wasn't going to mess with it. I said politicians.
That seems to be the answer. Is that what you have? You've got it, too.
Politicians.
Everybody down here had politicians. You got the hang of it now, Debbie?
I hope so.
What might have been.
I hope it's not too late.
I do,
Thurston,
too.
You ready?
Ready.
Wanda said, my husband, the postmaster, treats me just like a package. Last night he blanked me. How are we doing? Ready. Thurston. Private investigator. Wanda said my husband, the postmaster, treats me just like a package. Last night he blanked me.
Crushed me.
Yes! Very good, Thurston. That's what they like to do at the post office. They take your box and they smash it to smithereens.
That's what they do.
That's what they do.
You know what? When you sit here, you can't see, well, in this case, Thurston's face.
You can't.
No, look.
I never sat there.
You can't. All you see is that thing that sticks up.
Oh, that's right. You
can't see. Stick your little face up over the top there. Just want to get a good look at you in case we do run into each other to golf. Okay. I said crushed.
Crushed. Very good. Splendid answer. Nedra?
I said tore off my covering.
Tore off my covering?
Wow.
I think it's quite good because you're irresistible.
Really?
Yes.
I didn't know you cared.
I do care. You are irresistible,
Nedra. You're weird.
All right, Richard.
I think a lot of those postal employees are into bondage, so I said, tied me up.
Tied me up, yeah. Ho, ho, ho. That's a good one. What have you got for
us? He's a private investigator. Well, he doesn't have to search very far down here to find a crummy answer. I had a little spelling problem, too. I said mailed.
He mailed me. I like it the way you spelled it.
M-A-L-E-D.
Yeah. All right, Nathan. Right?
Now, if we thought of this with out of step, maybe a foot. Maybe it would be a match if he stamped.
Stamped? No. Stamp, that's, you know, with the rubber stamp.
I know.
Yeah, you tried to get away with it. Nice try,
I
Nathan.
Tried.
Chuck?
Chuck agrees with my friend next to me.
Exactly.
All right. No. So Thurston picks up one, and that's a score at the end of round one. 1-0 in his favor. Round two right after this. Here we go now. Before we go to round two, I just want to remind all of you who are watching today that next week I'm going to give you all of the rules and regulations and tell you when we are going to begin another exciting telephone contest where someone can win $5,000 and appear as an actor on a soap opera. And we're going to have all the soap opera stars as guests next week. All right. Here we go to round two. Thurston, you're ahead. You go first.
Pick the 18.
The 18th.
The 18th.
Mr. Thurston.
You're cute for a detective, you know that. Fred Fat is really fat. Not bad. When he wants a snack, he doesn't order stuffed potato skins. He orders stuffed blank skins. You don't play?
No.
Maybe you can help her out? Or him? There you go.
I'll tell you.
Okay. What's your brain not working, John? Join Chuck. All right, there's
stealing everyone.
Fred Fat is really fat. When he wants a snack, he doesn't order stuffed potato skins. He orders stuffed blank skins.
He orders stuffed elephant skins.
Elephant skins.
Yeah.
Boy, that is some big. What do you say to that, Nedra?
Elephant skins. How about that? Hey.
Very good. Hey. Richard?
Big is beautiful. Elephant skin.
Very good. What are you guys laughing at down here?
I was about to write elephant skins, and Nathan talked me out of it.
Oh, sure.
No.
When I looked over there and saw his card, and it said pig. And I... Because pig skin is like a football.
Come on, that's not a bad answer.
Two pig skins. That was a little... Collective boo for John and Nathan. I hope you don't have elephant skin, Charles. I mean, pig skin. Charles. Don't want to intimidate you. Did you steal from Nathan also? If you did, you deserve to be booed.
I don't speak to either one of those two fellows. Watermelon skin.
Oh, yeah. I think that's a good one. Isn't that a funny one? I thought that was quite amusing. So what do you got? You've got three. Debbie, this is for you. What? Harry said, I used to have a terrible problem with roaches until I hired Barbara Woodhouse.
Oh.
You know, she says the English trainer. Yes.
Right, roaches.
She came over and trained my roaches to blink. She's the well-known Emma. Walkies! Walkies! Ready, Debbie?
Oh, I hope so.
I think we're ready here. Harry said, you know who Barbara Woodhouse is, don't you?
Yes.
Harry said, I used to have a terrible problem with roaches until I hired Barbara Woodhouse. She came over and trained my roaches to blank.
Open the refrigerator themselves?
Oh.
I'm sorry.
Now, wait a minute. Hold everything. She doesn't want to spoil her record of giving rotten answers. That's two, Debbie.
I know.
Oh, boy. Nothing's going to happen here, but I got to go through the motions anyway.
You don't know.
Yeah, not a chance of opening the refrigerator door. There's not even any room to write that on the card. What do you say? If you say open the refrigerator door, I'm going to belt you right in the mouth. Don't say it.
I said, heel.
Heel. Which all is, right, that's okay.
As good as Debbie.
Heel. That's good.
Play dead.
There it is. That's it. Had a way to go, Nedra.
The devil laughed and he said, I'm going to send my friend Babs over there. Teach him how to die.
Die. Right. Okay, John.
Show's getting kind of weird, isn't it?
No.
So just my normal. I said show. Roll over and play dead.
That's it. Roll over and play dead. Die. All of that.
In that order, necessarily.
I know you're not going to believe that open refrigerator door was my first answer. But I didn't think you'd
and
say
it. And you threw it away.
So I said play dead.
Play dead. Charles.
Commit suicide.
Commit suicide. Debbie, are you getting the hang of it?
I hope so.
All right. 3-0 to score. Round 3, the final round, right after this. Here we go with the third round. Last round. Thurston, you're still ahead. You have to go first.
Stick with 18.
Gonna stick with the A team, eh? Three people play. The lower tier only. You ready, lower tier?
Let's go.
Popeye said, when I come home with aching muscles, there's only one thing that makes me feel better. I rub blank all over my body. All right, put it in the slot, Charles, and away we go. Thurston, Popeye said, when I come home with aching muscles, there's only one thing that makes me feel better. I rub blank all over my body.
Good old olive oil.
And away to go, Thurston.
Good old Thurston. Olive oil.
Nathan.
Why, of course.
Olive oil. You didn't steal.
What did they say?
Olive oil. Six for him. Now, the best you could do, Debbie, is match everybody and achieve a tie. It can be done, Debbie. Here we go.
Stay away from the Frigidaire.
Yeah. Now, wait a minute.
Okay.
Listen to this.
Okay.
Now. At the toupee store, Bald Bernie said, I'll tell you why I'm returning this toupee. Look, it has blank.
That's it.
That's the end of the...
That's the whole thing.
Okay.
Ready, upper tier? I know you don't know anything about toupees, Charles, but you've got to write an answer.
Is someone talking to moi?
Yeah. Moi. Put it in the slot, and away we go.
Oh, yeah. Forget that part.
Debbie, at the toupee store, Bald Bernie said, I'll tell you why I'm returning this toupee. Look, it has blank.
Lice.
Well... Lice is pretty good. I think you're finally getting the hang of it.
A little late.
Lice and dandruff would be another good response, but you need six lice, because that's your response here. McLean?
I feel so bad.
Why do you feel bad?
Because I said that this toupee had the ability to walk over and open the refrigerator door.
Oh, you said that. What a great toupee. I want to buy
one. Maybe that's what Debbie was going to say.
Ah, yes. Well,
I said dandruff.
You said dandruff. So that means Thurston wins the game. What do the rest of you have? Dandruff. All right. Yay, Thurston. Right there, if you would please. Debbie, it was a pleasure to meet you. Some gifts will be coming your way from the match game. Debbie Bowman. Hey, what do you say? Hey. We're going to switch to Hollywood Squares now. Bring on three more stars here. And there comes the rest of our set. John and I will trade places. Lots of excitement coming along. Don't go away. We'll be right back.
A member of our studio audience will receive Montgomery Ward's washer-dryer combo. Washer features two-speed, 10-cycle routine, and dryer sports large capacity for the large family loads. Furnished by Montgomery Ward. It's time for more of the match game. Hollywood Squares. Our win from Scarecrow and Mrs. King, Martha Smith. Larry Linville. From We've Got It Made, Bonnie Urseth. And taking over the star of the Hollywood Square, John Bowman.
Oh, smooth. We'll be right back to play Hollywood Squares after this. Be with us.
And now, John Bowman and the Hollywood Square.
Well, here he is, Thurston Lamar.
I thought she might have had you on the ropes there with that refrigerator stuff, Thurston, but you pulled it out in the end and you're out to Hollywood Squares. Attaboy. We got three brand new celebrities. Martha Smith. Yes. Bonnie Urseth. And Larry Linville. Bonnie Urseth. And husband, too. Last time you guys were here, we were discussing the baseball season, and now it's started. So I'm excited. We're big fans. We're all big fans. Yes. We've discussed this before. What's your favorite team?
Oh, gosh. Well, I'm from Minnesota, but it's hard to be a twins fan.
Address the mail from Minnesota, please, to Body U-R-S-E-T-H.
You all agree with me.
Hang in there, buddy.
No, I think I'll go for the Dodgers.
All right. Okay, what's your favorite team, Thurston?
Dodgers.
The Dodgers.
Yay!
It's a match. Okay.
I like the Mets. It's another big market. Come on, Thurston. Here we go to play Hollywood Square.
And we have a defending champ, as always. Her name is Pam Marks. Her numbers, $21,375 in one day. What's your favorite team, Pam?
Chicago Cubs.
All right, the Cubs.
Good. Well, we've gotten all the major markets covered now. Another of your favorite teams, I imagine, is the Match Game Hollywood Squares team, which matched you yesterday to the tune of $20,000. I'm sure you're going to just keep doing the same as yesterday if you can today.
I hope so.
I hope so, too. But Thurston may have something to say about that. We will play this game till you both hear the Time's Up bell. I may hear it, too. Whoever is ahead at that point is the winner. Goes on to play Super Match. Can be worth up to 30. Pam? You will start us off in the $100 game. Pick a star.
Let's go with Nedra.
Nedra Volz.
Okay.
According to the Star Wiener Report.
Star Wiener?
Star hyphen Wiener.
Wiener. Mm-hmm. Okay. Oh, I'm glad you put that hyphen in there, boy. You had me there for a minute.
Now, according to this report, when women over the age of 80 were asked if they still liked sex, did the majority say yes, no, or I don't remember?
Well, I'm not quite 80 yet. But if I was 80, and I will be, oh, son of a gun. I can't remember what happened yesterday, you understand? But I would say that they really don't care that much about it anymore. I don't think they forgot, but I think they just don't. Okay.
Is that yes, no, or I don't remember?
How did you read the first of it there?
Can we get a different report for women just around 75? According to this report, when women over 80 were asked if they still liked sex, did they say yes, no, or I don't remember? Majority.
No.
They said no. Okay, agree or disagree, Pam?
I agree.
The majority, the overwhelming majority, said yes, they did. You should have disagreed
with
me.
Lying.
I'm sorry to get so excited about that when you
they
didn't get the square,
lying.
But I think it's rather thrilling. The majority
lying.
Said yes.
I know.
91% of the women over 80 said yes, they still like sex.
They're just bragging.
Thurston Lamar, your move.
Gene, please.
Gene Rayburn.
Okay, Thurston.
What's longer, Gene? The average time it takes a person to get to sleep, or the time it takes to watch Johnny Carson's monologue?
His monologue runs about 11 minutes, I guess. Huh. Interesting question. The average person, if he's ready for sleep and fatigued, will probably zonk right out in less the time than it takes to... As a matter of fact, I often sleep through Johnny's monologue. It puts me to sleep.
So you say
only
that...
kidding, Johnny. It's a little joke. It's a comedy game show, you know? No, I say it takes less time to go to sleep.
Okay. So he says... The longer is the time it takes to watch Johnny Carson's monologue. What do you say, Thurston?
You go to sleep first.
So That's what I said.
Yeah, I agree with you.
Right.
I agree.
Okay. The longer is the time it takes to get to sleep. So you should have disagreed with Gene, and your opponent gets that square and evens everything up. I don't have the statistics, but it's something like 20 minutes or something for the average. 15 minutes. To an hour. It's a wise variable to fall asleep.
They're sick people.
Well, let's hope they're awake now. Pam, pick a star.
Let's go with Martha.
Okay, Martha Smith from Scarecrow and Mrs. King. You became a vegetarian, so you decide to let that your pet lion should give up eating meat, too.
Uh-huh.
Now, will this diet keep him as happy and healthy as always? Or is he soon going to die?
Oh, along with the pet lungfish that Bonnie had.
Yeah.
When you went on that long trip. This is really sad, dead pets again. My pet lion is not into vegetables. He will probably die soon.
Agree or disagree, Pam?
Carnivore.
That a vegetarian lion is dying.
I disagree.
A vegetarian lion is soon going to die. Martha knows her pet lion.
I know my lions.
That's who you're at with until 2:30 yesterday morning. Okay. Your opponent gets that square, and we'll be back to complete a $100 game right after these messages.
Stay tuned for more of the Match Game, Hollywood Squares Hour. Now, back to John Bauman and the Hollywood Squares.
50 for the challenger, 25 for the champ. But if you've been watching our show, these are rather paltry figures. They mean that we have plenty of time. Pick a star, Thurston. You're playing O.
Charles, to win.
Okay. Hi, Thurston. Okay, this is it, Ken.
This could increase your numbers substantially.
Notice Thurston. I don't get fingerprints on anything when I talk to Thurston.
Gotcha.
Go ahead, Thurston.
Charles, you're grooming your horse and you're in a hurry. Is it okay to use a vacuum cleaner on him? Or should you stick to brushing him by hand?
Don't look at me.
Well, I think a vacuum cleaner. Since the war, I've had trouble articulating. The point of the matter is, I touched something. I would not use a vacuum cleaner because of the heat factor on the delicate skin of a horse, especially if it was a racehorse. Okay. And besides that, there's no plug in my barn.
He says you should brush your horse by hand, not with a vacuum cleaner. Agree or disagree for the game, Thurston?
I disagree.
An audible, extended gasp from the audience.
In lieu of Thurston.
For everyone's information, it is okay to use a vacuum cleaner
right.
To groom your horse. Thurston is perfectly right. Now you know what you're talking about. And he gets the square and wins the first game. So there. Congratulations, Thurston Lamar. You nobly held your ground. $175 for you. It is perfectly okay to groom your horse with a vacuum cleaner as long as you have the right attachment. We will sweep the X's and O's off of the board and start a $200 game. Pam, it is your move.
Okay, let's go with Nedra.
Nedra Volz. Can you get a divorce in China? Or do you have to stay married whether you like it or not?
Well, I've never been in China. But can you get a divorce in China? Golly darn. Be a shame if you couldn't,
watch
especially
it.
If you couldn't stand the old guy. But I kind of think maybe you can't get a divorce in China.
She says you cannot get a divorce in China. Agree or disagree, Pam?
I agree.
You can get a divorce in China. It is not easy, but you can. You should have disagreed with Nedra, and your opponent gets that square.
Well,
all right, that's
it?
Another break for you, Thurston Lamar. Pick a star for an O.
Gene Rayburn again.
Gene
right,
Rayburn.
Thurston.
Gene, your brass is corroding.
Sure it is.
According to the book, How to Clean Everything, to make it look new again, should you rub it with a lemon wedge dipped in salt? Or should you dip it in tequila?
Now, wait a minute. I must have misunderstood. I just said my grass was...
No.
Brass.
Your brass.
Oh.
Brass.
That's why
brass.
We moved you to the front row.
That's right.
Brass.
Thank you, Charles. I don't know my brass from my grass.
How about your elbow?
Yes. Dip it in what?
Okay, you should either rub it with a lemon wedge dipped in salt, or you should dip it in tequila.
Well, the acid in the lemon should get rid of the oxidation, so I would use the salt in the lemon.
Okay.
And then you can use that in a drink later when you're...
He says you should rub it in a lemon with a lemon wedge dipped in salt. What do you say, Thurston?
I'm going to agree.
You should rub it with a lemon wedge dipped in salt. You're right to agree, and you get that square as well. So, Thurston has got a big leg up in this game. Two O's on the board, and we're going to find out what happens after this. Stick. All Our panel is corroding, but we're going to hang in there for still another segment. Thurston, you got the lead.
Pam?
You still got plenty of time. Pick a star.
Let's go with Larry DeBlock.
Yeah. You missed this one, you're going to give him a pretty big lead. Then you'll have to really put on a charge. Larry Linville,
yes.
According to a study of men who have had vasectomies...
Don't talk to me. What? Yes, yes.
If they had it to do all over again, would most of them do it again? Or did they wish they had kept their options open?
The majority?
Yes, most of them. The majority.
The majority are quite happy.
Okay. He says the majority would have the vasectomy again.
I agree.
90% would have the vasectomy again. You are perfectly right to agree. You get the square, and you do block. And that is a pivotal question in our game because you are thwarted, Thurston. Pick a star.
Charles.
Charles. Your rose has wilted. What can you do to get its stem back up again? Should you soak it in warm water? Or shock it with an ice pack?
I think the ice pack stinks. I would go with the soothing, sweet, lovely hot water on the stem.
He says, soak your wilted rose in warm water. Agree or disagree, Thurston?
I gotta disagree again.
You should soak it in warm water. No, in this case, you should have agreed with Charles. He knows his roses. And your opponent gets that square. Pam, big break for you. You're playing X.
Richard to win.
Richard Moll for the game and the lead. You meet an English girl in a pub. She tells you she'd like to spend a penny. Is she saying you're about to get lucky? Or is she on her way to the ladies' room?
Let me see. Spend a penny. I like it when they split the tab like that with you. Makes it nice. I bet she's saying I'm about to get lucky.
Okay. Agree or disagree, Pam, for the game. Spend a penny means you're gonna get lucky.
I agree.
She's on her way to the ladies' room. You should have disagreed with Richard, and your opponent gets that square and blocks you there. So, you survive. Thurston, pick a star.
McLean to win.
Okay.
Sure. I knew you'd come around to me, Thurston. I knew.
McLean.
Yeah.
Your daughter's new boyfriend, the punk rocker, has an IQ that hovers around 40.
That high.
Pay attention, McLean. This could be a series.
I'm listening.
Now, look. Can he be hypnotized? Or is it a lost cause?
I don't understand what the question is. My daughter has a punk rocker.
Yeah, basically, can a person whose IQ is 40 be hypnotized?
Yeah. Oh, that's I see. Is a person with an IQ of a houseplant capable of being put...
You got it.
Night-night.
Couldn't have written it better myself.
Yes. IQ has nothing to do with your ability to be hypnotized or not.
Agreed.
And I am sure Thurston will agree. And I rest my case. Thank you.
Agree or disagree, Thurston, for the game.
I'm going to agree for the game.
Amazing to me, but it is a lost cause to hypnotize a person with an IQ that low. You should have disagreed with McLean, and your opponent gets that square and blocks you. So, Pam, pick a star. We've got to keep it moving now. It's real close.
Okay, let's go with Bonnie.
Okay, Bonnie Urseth for an X. A woman with a 34A bust wants to increase it to a 34C. According to Arnold Schwarzenegger's Body Shaping for Women, can she accomplish this with exercise? Or will she have to resort to plastic surgery?
A to C, huh? That's a lot. I think she's going to need a little plastic surgery.
What do you think, Pam?
Yeah, I agree.
Plastic surgery it is. You're right to agree, and you get the square. Okay, Thurston, you're playing O. Pick a star for me.
Martha to block.
You missed this one. The game and the lead goes to Pam. Martha Smith, your 3-year-old son and 4-year-old daughter are always taking their clothes off and playing doctor.
Silly thing.
Now, according to Dr. Joyce Brothers, should you punish them and make them stop, or will they probably stop on their own?
They will probably stop about 34 years down the line on their own. Yeah.
But that's on
their
own.
Let them go. According to Dr. Joyce Brothers.
Agree or disagree, Thurston, for a very important block. She says those kids who play doctor will stop on their own.
I agree. They'll stop on their own.
They will probably stop on their own.
No, Thursday.
Yes. Well done. You're right to agree. They stop playing doctor Thursday afternoon and go to Palm Springs for the weekend. Pam?
Nathan, please.
We have a completely full board. There's only one place to go. This might be our pivotal question for the whole day.
Sure.
Nathan,
come to me
Cook.
Now.
It's as simple as this. There are four X's and four O's up on the board. Order doesn't matter anymore. Whoever gets five symbols wins the game. That means you get this question right, Pam. You win, you miss it, Thurston wins. Nathan, you're an average millionaire.
I like the ring of that.
Do you have a Sears credit card in your wallet? Or is that beneath you?
The average millionaire?
Mm-hmm.
Wouldn't be caught dead with a Sears credit card. Are you kidding me?
Oh. Agree or disagree, Pam, for the game.
I disagree.
The average millionaire has a Sears credit card in his wallet. You're right to disagree. You get the square, and you win the game. You disagreed at what you knew was a critical moment. Congratulations. Takes a lot of nerve. The bell means the time is up. She has done it. Second day in a row. $350, Pam Marks. Whoa. Zip right over there if you can stand up. Make your way to Gene Rayburn. Get set for your shot at the big money. Well,
I had the shot set.
McLean and I were talking during match game, saying what a good player you were and how you were probably going to win a lot of money on our show. What I think really happened here is you are a very good player, and you just ran into another good player in the person of Pam. That game couldn't have gotten much closer. You got $275 in our thanks. Thurston Lamar.
Thank you.
Gene,
okay,
take it away.
Okay, John, here we are with the champ. We'll be back with her and the stars for a go of the big dough right after this.
And now, here to play the super match is Gene Rayburn.
Thank you, Gino. Here we go. Ready. Pam is ready. Here we go with a super match where she could win up to $30,000. Let's get right to it. We polled an audience not too long ago and said, write down your best answer to this. Blank hose. If you give us the answer they wrote down most often, you get $1,000. For the second, it's $500. And for the third, $250. Let's see who will offer a good suggestion here.
Let's go with Bonnie.
Pantyhose.
Pantyhose is hers.
John?
Need I even speak, but I'll say garden hose.
Right. McLean.
We have garden and panty.
Garden and panty, right.
Uh-huh. Okay, then try fire.
Fire hose. Now you have the choice. Do you want fire hose, garden hose, or panty hose? Or one of your own?
I want pantyhose.
You do want pantyhose.
Hold on, I'll just take mine off.
Take yours off and give them to her. All right, she says pantyhose will be under the $1,000 response. You think she's right, audience?
Yes.
All right, let's find out all together right now. First, we reveal the $250 response. Garden hose. All right, that's the one that John gave you. The $500 response says pantyhose.
What?
Fire hose must be
the second. Who did we? Who was in this audience? Oh, it was 100 firemen.
No. It was your average audience like this. Wouldn't you have said fire hose? You just told me you'd say pantyhose. All right, Steve, slide it. Fire hose it is. Well, Pam, you've got $500. Now it's time for the head-to-head match with any star of your choosing. And after you've made that decision, that star will reveal the hidden number, and we will multiply your $500 by whatever number is revealed. Now, more than ever, it's important for you to get lucky and pick the one with the big 3-0.
Well, I won with Bonnie yesterday, so let's try it again today.
Think Bonnie might have the big one today?
Yeah.
She had a 20 yesterday. Let's see what she's got today. A 10, so you're playing for $5,000.
That's pretty good. Chicken feed.
That's so good.
Oh, help me, guys. Right after
you. All right.
Help me. Write something down.
Good luck. Here we go, Bonnie. Blank jar. J-A-R. blank jar. Blank jar. Blank jar. Now, Pam, we want to see if you collect the $5,000 by matching Bonnie. What do you say?
Cookie jar.
Cookie jar? Sounds good to me. Sounds good to us down here. Cookie jar, Bonnie.
Well, you know, I can, and I use those glass jars, but I really like cookies better.
Ah! Very good. Another $5,000. Another autograph. And away to go, Pam. She's very happy. She's added $5,000 to her winnings, and that means she now has $27,225.
Fantastic.
Fantastic. Yeah, we'll be back with her and the stars right after this.
Inventive use of these cards.
Now, we're all curious to know which of the stars had the big number. So would you all grab your tabs and give it a yank? Ready, set, go. Richard Moll had a big
Richard
three
that was there. Torturous pull there, Richard.
All right.
Now, we should thank McLean for the most inventive use of the match game cards so far. He had a jacket made out of them. Terrific, McLean.
Excellent. Very well done. All the old cards, right. All right, Pam, we'll see you tomorrow. I'm Gene Rayburn inviting you to join us tomorrow.
John Bowen saying so long for the Match Game Hollywood Squares era. See you then.
A member of our studio audience will receive Commodore 64 computer featuring 64K memory, full-size keyboard, holographic sprite sound capability, music composer cartridge, and program reference guide furnished by Commodore. This is Gene Woods speaking for the Match Game, Hollywood Squares Hour, a Mark Goodson television production.